What up, y'all? I'm Bokeh Bob, and today we're going to be checking out the Daring Run DR-70F. Before we get started, I always like to make it clear that this keyboard was sent to me for review from Divinity and Daring Run. However, all opinions are my own and from my experiences using the keyboard. I usually use the keyboard for about a week before releasing my review, along with building the keyboard on stream. I stream both here on YouTube and on Twitch, so if you're interested in live stream, I suggest you check them out. Also, it'd be greatly appreciated if you can like and most importantly subscribe to the channel, as it is a great way to support me and allows me to bring more reviews like these to you in the future. Daring Run is a new studio that has stemmed from Wind Studios, who have brought us the likes of the Wind X, Wind X 98, and the Wind X 65, and I believe a couple other boards. Daring Run is their budget studio, which seems to be aiming to compete with the likes of QWERTY Keys, Slash Neo, and Meletrix. Having experience with a board from all of these studios, I am pleased to say that Daring Run is for sure ready to give these other studios a run for their money. The DR-70F is currently in stock and has an active group buy on Daring Run's website or on divinity.com for US customers. I'll put a link in the description below so you can check it out. The in-stock color options were limited, while more colors are offered in the active group buy. Pricing starts at $139 for in-stock and $149 for the group buy. Hot swap wired and hot swap Bluetooth PCBs are offered as in-stock options. The group buy sale also adds a wired solder PCB to the mix. For colors, in-stock options are as follows: Anno Black, Creamy White, Anno Silver, and Anno Red. For the group buy sale, the colors offered include the same as the in-stock options, but they also add E-White, E-Pink, Anno Blue, and Anno Orange. Keep in mind, for the in-stock sale, some colors may have sold out, and if you're set on that color, you'll have to buy it through the group buy. I'll put on screen now the key features and a list of what is included in the kit when ordering. The wired hot swap and solder PCBs do use Vial, which is great. However, the Bluetooth PCB uses LDN software, which seems to be a newer software which doesn't seem that user-friendly. I haven't heard of it. If you have, let me know in the comments. However, I was able to figure out how to use it, but it did take a little bit to get used to. The ease of use with either Via or Vial is great. However, with the LDN software, not so much. So keep that in mind if you are deciding to purchase this keyboard. My second point is I just like to hit on the mounting styles. There are two mounting systems offered here. It comes standard with a gasket mount. However, a sandwich mount aluminum plate is also offered. The sandwich mount is my preferred sound signature as it felt and sounded more full and lively. I'll include two sound tests so you can see which one you like the best. Now let's check this board out and see how it sounds. Hit the B-roll, baby. We'll be right back. At $139, this board is a straight banger in my opinion. As custom keyboards continue to get cheaper, we keep seeing the likes of QWERTYKEYS, Neo, Meletrix, and now Daring Run offer an outstanding experience and product for a fraction of the price that we're used to seeing not even a year ago. The quality of machining and anno and coding is amazing, and so is the unboxing experience. This keyboard case is better than any of the cases I've gotten any of my high-end keyboards. Yes, this Daring Run case is light years better than the Singa or Drift Mechanics case, which if you know higher end mechanical keyboards, those are some of the best around. I always hit on perks and quirks in my reviews, along with give you recommendations to buy the product. I'm going to cut straight to the case. If you like this layout and the way this board looks, buy it. The value you get with this board is absolutely outstanding. It sounds great, looks great, and it feels great. It's almost a no-brainer if the board has interested you. Keep in mind this board has more of a stiffer typing feel, so if you don't like a stiff typing feel, then you probably want to stay away. When it comes to quirks, I can only think of two things. First, the LDN software for the Bluetooth PCB, it's pretty mid. I would have liked if they used VIA or VIAL, however I'm not sure if that's possible with Bluetooth PCBs yet. Secondly, the plate material options are pretty much non-existent. The board comes with a polycarbonate plate, but the only other option to buy is an aluminum plate. Hopefully they release plate files in the future so people can experiment with other plate materials. What are your thoughts on the Daring Run DR-70F, and what do you think of the current war going on within the budget category? I call it a war because we keep seeing all these new budget boards come out at a lower and lower price. I think it's great for us consumers, and we won't see anything but prices continue to drop and more innovation in the space because these guys keep fighting each other. As always, check out some of my content here. Make sure to like and subscribe, and most importantly, have a good rest of your week. Bokeh Bob out.